right in front of me. It cost us the outright national championship. So today's game is more than Saturday football in the South. For Ole Miss, Eli, and his teammates, it's time to put an end to four decades of frustration. For LSU, Matt Mock and the Tigers, it's time to once again play spoiler while increasing their own hopes of an SEC and a national championship game. Boy, what a game it's going to be.
It's goosebump time in Oxford, Mississippi. It's Ole Miss against LSU. Welcome you to the Home Depot SEC on CBS from Vaught Hemingway Stadium in Oxford as LSU comes to town to take on the Rebels of Ole Miss. SEC battle. The third-ranked Tigers of LSU with a 9-1 record against the Rebels of Ole Miss, who come in 8-2. Good afternoon, everybody. Vern Lundquist along with Todd Blackledge and Jill Arrington. In their careers, most athletes only can hope for a handful of days like this one, a day bursting with opportunity and potential. For LSU, the dream remains attainable, a dream of winning their first national championship since 1958. They're getting a little help from Michigan, but they must win this one. You've just heard from legendary coach John Vaught. He is now 94 years of age. He was 54 the last time Ole Miss claimed an SEC championship. They can get into the championship game if they win today's battle. Here are the standings, which show Ole Miss with 6 consecutive victories in the SEC. LSU 1 back at 5-1. Well, Todd, it's all set. I think we're going to enjoy this, and I particularly am looking forward to the Ole Miss offense against this LSU defense.
Yeah, it's a classic battle of strength versus strength. The Ole Miss offense leads the league in scoring, in passing, in total offense. This LSU defense, the stingiest defense in all of college football, and according to Alabama quarterback Brody Croyle, who played both of them, every bit as good as the Oklahoma defense. Interestingly enough, both of these units take their cue from a senior All-American. For Ole Miss, it's their quarterback, Eli Manning, and he is better than the average fan possibly understands, because aside from his physical skills, which are immense, it's how his mind works that sets him apart from other quarterbacks. His ability to see and recognize things quickly and manage the game at the line of scrimmage, I think, is what makes him special. And that will be critical today against an LSU defense that is going to come at him from a lot of different angles, give him a lot of different looks. His ability to see, to set the protections, to get his team on the same page, and then when he has all that done, to deliver the play will be critical today against an LSU defense that is as good as he's faced. Now, speaking of this LSU defense, they take their cue from their senior defensive tackle, Chad Lavallee. He is the anchor of this defense. Even though this defense loves to blitz and bring people from a lot of directions, it all centers around the guy inside. He leads this team with 6 sacks and 12 more tackles behind the line of scrimmage. But he's a coach's dream, which means he plays every play like it's his last, and this entire LSU defense feeds off of the play and the effort of Chad Lavallee.
Just a moment ago, just a little enthusiasm on the LSU sideline. It is a spectacular mid-November afternoon in the South, 73 degrees, 57% humidity, and a forecast of partly cloudy. Now Baton Rouge and Oxford separated by 345 miles. This is the 92nd meeting between the two, but somewhat shockingly, it's only the 11th meeting ever here in Oxford. For years, they played the game either in Jackson or Baton Rouge because of the size of this stadium. It now holds 60,500. I promise you there are many more than that who are here. LSU won the toss. They've elected to take the option in the second half, so Ole Miss will receive as we get underway. Chris Jackson will kick off for the Tigers. Chris Collins and Brian Brown are deep for the Rebels of Ole Miss. Brian Brown at the 6. The 20. Down at the 27. Well, usually Jill Arrington is down on the sideline, but for the moment, she's about 2 blocks away. Jill?
Well, Vern, there's tailgating, and then there's tailgating in the Grove. I'm right here in the Grove in the middle of the Ole Miss campus. This is one of the most unique atmospheres in all of college football. Now, these Ole Miss fans know it's been 40 years since they've been SEC champions, and today they have their shot to clinch the SEC West. In fact, there'll be over 20,000 fans right here in the Grove, even after kickoff, in anticipation of today's big game.
And that anticipation of success, Jill, is fulfilled on the first play as Eli Manning finds Mike Espy.
Well, LSU is in good position as we take a look at what Eli Manning has done throughout his career. Holder of 45 records, many of those records previously held by his father, Archie. But he is playing his best football, and this is his final year in Oxford.
That's a first down in the 11-yard gain. First down, backs are split. Tremaine Turner is the running back. And Manning with two wideouts left and right. There's a toss to the right side, the fullback, Lorenzo Townsend, and he lost a yard. Well, you've been introduced to Eli Manning. Let's introduce you to the Earthlink starting lineups. And up front for Ole Miss, kind of miraculously, this offensive line is intact. Three of them injured 2 weeks ago in the win at Auburn. Stallings, Buckles, Sawyer, Johnson, and Woodruff are back on the field. Turner and Townsend in the backfield. Chris Collins and Mike Espy, the wideouts. And Eric Rice is the tight end. And as you can see, Ole Miss with great success on the opening drive of their last 8 games. Second down and 11. Blitz from the corner. Manning steps up, avoids it, goes deep, and overthrows Eric Rice, his tight end.
And he had him. He had Eric Rice open, and he did a marvelous job of stepping up slightly to avoid the unblocked guy because LaRon Landry was coming unblocked.
And here is the defense for LSU. And they are outstanding. Spears and Hill on the corners, Williams and Lavallee in the middle. The linebackers, Eric Alexander, Lionel Turner, and Cameron Vaughn. And in the secondary, you've got Webster, Landry, Jack Hunt, and Travis Daniels.
This is where LSU excels. Third down and long. They are very, very difficult. And LSU, another one of those categories where they lead the conference.
Here's the blitz. Manning goes deep right side to man. Coverage, and it's incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
See, when they give you third and long, most defenses play soft. LSU does just the opposite. When they get third and long, they like to bring pressure and force you to throw to a short, hot receiver. That's exactly what they did there. Will Muschamp, the defensive coordinator, works in harmony with Nick Saban, who is a defensive-minded head coach, and they are very aggressive, particularly on third down.
Here's Cody Ridgeway, and he will kick to the nation's leading punt returner. The return is on all the way. Ridgeway's line drive sends Skylar Green way back. Whoa, what a start.
What a punt. Unreturnable and then out of bounds inside the 10.
That is a 57-yard punt for Ridgeway. Out of bounds at the 7. 7-0 Ole Miss as Travis Johnson returns one, officially 6 yards on the first offensive play for LSU. The 12th interception of the season for the Rebels. They get on the board first.
And remember, it all goes back to the tremendous punt by Cody Ridgeway that went out inside the 10 and forced LSU to start that first possession deep in their own territory.
Now Lee Rogers will kick off. The deep man
are Devery Henderson and Skylar Green, both dangerous. But this will go 5 yards into the end zone, touchback. And let's go back to the touchdown.
Well, here is where Travis Johnson is going to start out. He's right here. So he is going to be in man-to-man coverage, and as Clayton comes across, he comes with him. And watch him just kind of read the route, and then it's not a very good throw by Matt Mock. It's outside, and Travis Johnson in position to make the play. He read it all the way, and then he was helped by a little bit of a wide throw by Matt Mock.
And some pressure by Josh Cooper, who didn't go for the play fake at all. First down and 10, LSU from the 20. Double tight end set. They hand it off left side. LP Spence, the middle linebacker, meets Justin Vincent and nails him.
Now, when you look at these two teams on paper, there really is not much comparison. Spence is going to come right here. He's going to shoot right through the gap and beat the block of Rudy Nisswanger. And when you look at the lines, LSU is much bigger up front than Ole Miss. But what Ole Miss lacks in size, they make up for in tremendous quickness. They're a slanting, stunting defense, and they have a lot of quickness in their front seven.
Left side, Mark finds Clayton, and Clayton works out to the 29-yard line. And let's check this LSU offense. And they open up with three wideouts. The offensive line, Whitworth, Nisswanger, Wilkerson, Peterman, and Rodney Reed. His 45th start on the right side. Justin Vincent, Skylar Green, and Michael Clayton, the three wides, along with Devery Henderson. And Eric Edwards is the tight end. Nick Saban, fifth-year head coach. Third and one. From just short of the 30-yard line. David Jones is at second tight end, and Vincent gets the first down at the 31-yard line.
Pretty good run defense by Ole Miss, but they didn't need very much to make the first down.
Now, here is the Ole Miss defense. They've improved against the run this year. They're still susceptible to the big play and the pass. Cooper, Mitchell, Daniel Booth starts for McKinley Boykin, Charlie Anderson. They play a 4-2-5. The two linebackers are Wade and Spence. And then the five defensive backs, Travis Johnson with the touchdown, Robinson Oliver, Travis Blanchard, Vaughn Hutchins the other, and there is David Cutcliffe, head coach, Ole Miss. First and 10, backs in the eye. Mock with a play fake on first down, deep down the middle. Devery Henderson, incomplete. Had a chance for it, slipped through.
Yeah, they had a chance because neither one of the Ole Miss defenders knew where the football was. And they went after the guy that has given up the most big plays for Ole Miss. That's Vaughn Hutchins, number five. That's who they went after. And Eric Oliver, the safety, is going to come to try to help, but he didn't know where the football was. But I think just flashing in front of Devery Henderson made Henderson lose his concentration on the ball.
Here's Vaughn Hutchins. Just back, the defensive coordinator said he's had a chat with Mr. Hutchins this week and said, we really need you to play well, or we've got Tremaine McBride behind you, and he might get in the game. Second and 10. Flags down, and it'll be a dead ball foul. Bring it back.
Archer snap. False start. Moving the offensive line. 5 yard penalty. Main second down.
Thomas Ritter, our referee, and let's check in with Jill Arrington.
Well, Vern, both coaches told us one of the keys to the game would be controlling that line of scrimmage. Well, for LSU, their left tackle, Andrew Whitworth, has a touch of the flu. Now, he was given fluids before the game, and Todd, big games like this, sometimes you just have to suck it up and stay on the field.
Yeah, I mean, you know, a lot of guys are banged up and not feeling great, but you kind of forget that in a game like this.
Here's Clayton out on the left side. Got some room. First down, LSU out to the 45.
Well, that was a big play because second and 15 is not a great situation to be in. The chances of you being on a third and long are pretty high. Well-executed wide receiver screen. Whitworth, who Jill was just talking about, and Nisswanger, the two guys out leading that play. And Michael Clayton, one of the best players in the conference, get his hands on the football early. That's his second catch. And you see the explosion up the field after he makes the short grab.
Clayton winds up
trying to go for touchdowns rather than set up field goal.
Again, three down. The corner blitz is timed perfectly. The pass is complete, but Joseph Addai is going to be forced out of bounds at the 28-yard line. So they came from the corner.
This is a defense that believes in pressure pretty much as LSU does. They do it a little differently, but they like to bring pressure often. And the screen pass was fairly well set up, but good pressure forced the throw, and Addai stepped out of bounds.
That's going to bring on Chris Jackson. He's only 2-4 this season. Ryan Gaudé kicked most of the year, and he might be kicking into a little bit of a breeze. Here's the boot. It's a good one. And he nailed it, breeze or not.
One of the things about Chris Jackson, he's a true freshman, and as the season has progressed, he's gotten more comfortable kicking off the grass instead of off the tee. No question about that one there.
Through the years, in 1959, Billy Cannon's midnight run on an 89-yard punt return sparked the Tigers to the upset win. Later that season, Ole Miss got revenge in the 60 Sugar Bowl, and in 61, LSU won another squeaker, 10-7, preventing the Rebs from becoming number one in the nation. And in 1962, Ole Miss won 15-7 on the way to an undefeated season and an SEC title.
Unlike many who are a part of our broadcast, I remember those games vividly. Oh, they were good under John Vaught. And Paul Dietzel, 79 years of age, is now moved back to Baton Rouge. He was the head coach from 55 to 61. Charlie Mack took over at LSU, Charles McClendon. Here's Bryant. Brown got some room.
Wow.
Good tackle. Benny Brazell, world-class sprinter on the track team at LSU. Well, those golden years at LSU in 1959, the only loss was to this LSU team, 60-10-0-1. In 61, 9-2, lost in the Cotton Bowl to Texas, 12-7. And in 62, they were SEC champions with a 10-0 mark. First down and 10. This is only the fourth play from scrimmage for Ole Miss. Keep away from Eli. Here's Turner going right. Out to the 33-yard line. That last drive was 12 plays and took 7 minutes. Now, here are the rankings in 1959. Syracuse, Ole Miss, and LSU. Ole Miss was declared the national champions by three different groups. Berryman, Billingsley, Dunkel, and Sagarin. And then in 1960, and keep in mind, there were 7 or 8 different organizations that ranked national titles. Ole Miss then won it by Lipkenhaus in 1962. The one they say is undisputed was awarded by the Football Writers Association.
Kind of like the computer mumbo jumbo issue.
That's right.
Now on the BCS.
Second down, the handoff. Speaking of field, back to you fellas. All right, thank you, Tim. Third down and short here.
I bet Eli Manning hopes he has that kind of protection for most of this afternoon. That was about 7 seconds to throw the football.
Here's Manning going right, and it's tipped. And you said you thought tip balls at the line of scrimmage would be key today.
Well, for a couple reasons. Number one, LSU's defensive linemen and outside linebackers are tall, and they have long arms. And number two, Ole Miss philosophy is to play to the stick. So if they have third down and 4, they're going to throw a short pass to get the first down. They don't throw deep on third and 4. And right there getting in on the football is Kirsten Pittman.
And that brings on Cody Ridgeway for the punt, 57 yards on his first effort. Skylar Green, who's averaging 23.7 per return. And this one is returnable from the 21. Comes back to the right, gets a good block.
Uh-oh. He's
almost
dangerous.
Corey Webster got a really nice block to help get him around the corner. A 44-yard punt and 6 on the return. 94 years young. He hits 500 golf balls every day. Coach John Vaught. Well, some of these folks obviously made a detour from Baton Rouge to New Orleans to get up here to Oxford. Time of possession, 7:17 to 2:48, and 15 plays to 7 thus far. 7-3, however, on the strength of an interception return for a touchdown. Here's Vincent trying to get outside. Nice pursuit from Justin Wade, number 51.
And so far, what we're seeing from Ole Miss is not only fast pursuit, but good, solid tackling. And that's going to be important throughout this day. This talented group of running backs that LSU has, the big physical offensive line, it'll be important to tackle well through the course of the day, because LSU's not going to abandon their running game. They've been averaging 230 yards a game rushing during these last four games.
Second down and nine. High formation. Mark, play fake, steps up. He'll run. Tackled at the 35-yard line. That'll bring up third and three. L.P. Spence, the middle linebacker, 25 years of age. Spence tackling the 24-year-old Matt Mock.
Now, the thing about Matt Mock is he can run the football. In fact, when he first started playing at LSU, he was better known as a runner than he was as a thrower. But when he hurt his foot last year, it forced him to kind of learn to see the field and learn the mental aspect of playing the quarterback position a little bit more intensely. And so now he's not as inclined to run, but he still certainly has that as part of his arsenal.
Third down and two. Here's Mark. The flag is down. The pass complete out of the backfield to Joseph Adai. Let's see if this one is called back.
Yeah, it's going to be called back because it's a dead ball. They blew the ball dead, which would suggest that LSU was not set on the line of scrimmage.
Prior to the snap, false start. Moving in the offensive line. 5-yard penalty.
We all became familiar with Matt Mock in the SEC championship game against Tennessee. Rowan Davey was injured. Mock came on and became the game's MVP. Scored two touchdowns as the Tigers upset second-ranked Tennessee 31-20. LSU's first SEC title since 1988. That was them. This is third and seven.
And that was a costly penalty because then there's another one right there. Now, Rodney Reed, now what's happening is Matt Mock is trying to change protections. He's trying to check off and do some things at the line of scrimmage, and it's creating a little anxiety with the guys up front. And so it's
all start moving the offensive line. 5-yard penalty remains third down.
Now the burden is on these veteran offensive linemen. If they can't hear Matt Mock, and here's where the penalty is right here. If they can't hear, then they've got to look at the football. I mean, Matt Mock needs to move up and communicate loudly to everybody, and then those linemen have to turn their heads in and watch the ball move and not listen to the snap count.
And Todd, that is the third false start penalty in the game. Now comes the corner blitz. Here's Mock. Gets good protection, but now it breaks down, and he is sacked, and Ole Miss is going to get the ball back. He had time. They started third and three.
Yeah, third and three, and they made the conversion with the quick throw, but there was movement. So they went back, and then they went back again, and third and 12 is difficult. Even against the 116th ranked pass defense in America, third and 12 is hard.
Donnie Jones on for the season, just under a 42-yard average. Here is Mike Espy, who averages 8.1 per return. Left footer, and that's low. Line drive, bounces, and taken by Espy on one hop. Good field position now for Ole Miss, but they still are looking for their first down of the ball game. Monday on CBS, it's the most intense CSI Miami yet. A victim is shot, then attacked by a shark, and the prime suspect is one of CSI's own. Don't miss an all-new CSI Miami Monday at 10, 9 Central on CBS.
One of the things I think Ole Miss wants to try to do is to wear this LSU defense out and make them move. I wouldn't be surprised to see a bootleg or something here, some kind of a misdirection play to try to make this defense run side to side.
That's Turner out of the backfield setting up. They look for him, and what a good read by Corey Webster. Well, Peyton Manning is in a hotel room in Buffalo, New York, watching this game, and they do have similarities, don't they?
Well, they look so similar. I mean, their body mannerisms, the way they throw the football, their mechanics playing the quarterback position. You know, I hate to say this, I love Peyton, but I think that Eli maybe is a little bit more mobile and does a little bit more of the speed, but both of these guys communicate so well with their teammates. They talk to their receivers, and they really play the position in a similar fashion.
Loss of three on the last play. Here's Turner going to the right side. And he gets across the 50 to the 49. Well, Peyton Manning and the Colts take on Buffalo tomorrow. The third brother, who started out as a wide receiver here at Ole Miss and then had a spinal cord, not an injury, but they diagnosed a narrow spinal cord. Cooper Manning is here with his wife, Ellen. And you know the Manning family well. You say he's the funny one, huh?
Yeah, he's the funny one. That's him sitting next to Archie. This is Cooper right here. That's Archie right there with the headsets and the hat and sunglasses. And, yeah, it's a great family. I mean, and Cooper is the biggest fan that Eli and Peyton have.
Here's Eli, right side, delivers. It's caught by Kerry Johnson, and that will, yes, it will be enough for the first down. First Ole Miss first down of the game, Jack Hunt with the tackle.
Now the key when LSU wants to blitz, and here's where the blitz is going to come, is Eli finding, okay, where's the safety? That's my best matchup. If Jack Hunt is coming over to play man-to-man and he's off, that's where I'm going with the football. Let's pick up the blitz and let's find the best matchup that we have on the field. And that's exactly what he did that time.
Well, they have the full complement of wide receivers. They use six. And that was Kerry Johnson with the catch. Tate Biddle is on now. Play fake Manning. Here's what we were talking about. And he's going deep to Biddle, who's got a man, and it's tipped away incomplete.
Nice play by Travis Daniels. He was beat on the play. It was a good throw, it was a good call, and it was excellent makeup speed by Travis Daniels to get to the football. Biddle is the fastest receiver. Daniels gets there, and it actually hits him in the back. There is no face guarding in college football. But he had good closing speed to the receiver to get his body in position.
Travis Daniels, a junior from Hollywood, Florida, at 6'1", 181. Mm-hmm. On third down, a second down now, and 10. Manning goes from the spread. LSU with four down, they bring only four. Quick flip, right side. And that is Mario Hill, another of his complement of wide receivers. He gets five, it'll be third and five.
Take another look at this play. A couple things. Not only did Biddle have to worry about Travis Daniels, he also had to fight the sun, looking right back into the sun on that long ball. And I hope he could see it better than I could on that replay.
Jesse Daniels has come on as a sixth back. That's the end of one from Vaught-Hemingway Stadium in Oxford, Mississippi. 7-3. We'll return after this message and this word from your local station. We all welcome you back to Oxford, Mississippi. Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge, Jill Arrington. 7-3 Ole Miss. The touchdown came on a Travis Johnson interception return. A 45-yard field goal put LSU on the boards. And now third and five for Eli Manning and the Rebels of Ole Miss. Stunts by the LSU defense, and the pass deep right side is incomplete. And that's going to mean Jonathan Nichols will have a chance to come on and kick a very lengthy field goal. He's missed only one this year. Well, impressions of the first quarter.
Well, I think the story so far has been the Ole Miss defense and their ability to play. They got the first touchdown, the only touchdown in the game with the interception. LSU has rushed the ball 10 times for only 13 yards, so it's really been the Ole Miss defense that has kind of set the tone in the ballgame so far.
Here's a Lou Groza finalist, Jonathan Nichols, 23 of 24 for the year. And this one,
punt. It was a pooch punt. They snapped it directly to Nichols, and he tried to pooch punt it, and it was not very effective. You know, that might have been a stretch for him. His long on the year was 54. He has made three of over 50 yards, but they were trying to play field position and pin LSU back again. This time, it kind of backfired on Jonathan Nichols.
LSU has the ball when we come back. NFL doubleheader tomorrow, Indianapolis at Buffalo, New England at Houston, Jacksonville at the Jets, and Pittsburgh at Cleveland. First game, second game, Oakland at Kansas City. And it all begins with the NFL today, tomorrow, 12 noon Eastern time. First down and 10, here's Malk with a handoff, and a nice bit of run defense by Corey Robinson, number 96. Well, let's bring you up to date on the SEC East, where things are a little complex. Georgia wins today. And they complete their schedule 6-2, Florida 6-2. They're finished. They've got Florida State next week out of conference. Tennessee with one game remaining. And in the event of a three-way tie, we'll spend an extra half hour and explain what's going to happen.
And even though they're done in the conference, those games next week are vitally important because we're going to revert to the BCS rankings, and wins or losses next week will affect them.
Mark, right side, Clayton with his first catch. And the tackle made at the 25. All right, thank you, Tim.
Well, I think those three teams, we just saw Oklahoma, we just saw USC, and we're watching LSU. I think those are the three most talented teams in college football this year.
Here's Mark on third down. Batted down. It'll be fourth. Charlie Anderson, I think, or it's Jamie Mitchell, number 77, who got there.
Again, it's the Ole Miss defense that has taken the initiative of this game. Watch the push they get inside. And they get their hands up. It's Jamie Mitchell. You called it, Vern. Got his hands up. Couldn't get to the quarterback for a sack, but got his hands up and knocked the pass down.
Donnie Jones on the punt on fourth down and six. Mike Espy will return it. And the block is on, and they got it.
No, they didn't. They got Donnie Jones. I don't know
how. Just missed it.
I don't know how they didn't get the football. Other than the fact that when you teach guys to block punts, you teach them to go to the block point, not to go to the kicker. If they would have gone to the block point of where that football was going to come off, they would have gotten a block punt. Instead, they went to where Donnie Jones was, and they ran into him and didn't get the football. And this is probably going to be an automatic first down for LSU.
Yep. Charles Clark, number 20. I am just shocked that they didn't get it.
I am too, because they were right there and had a great chance.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker on the defense. 15 yards, automatic first down.
It was a nice call to go after the punt. LSU has very wide splits on their punt team, and there's Clark right up the middle, but see, he's got to go for where the ball is coming off the foot, not directly at the punter. Charles Clark has to angle that off and not go at the punter. Because if you miss the football, you're going to get the penalty. And that's exactly what happened to him there.
So, an automatic first down. In a 7-3 game, the ball comes out to the 41-yard line. New life for Mark and the team, and he goes deep on first down. Incomplete. Intended for Skylar Green, number 5. It'll be 2nd and 10.
Now LSU, what they need to do is capitalize on that big play. You know, they get the turnaround and don't have to punt the football, and they get the ball back in good field position. They haven't had very good field position so far, and Matt Mock and this offense need to capitalize.
2nd down and 10. Mock, 6 of 11 thus far. Hand off. This is Sharon Carey, number 2. He missed 4 games with a knee injury. And as you said a while ago, he's never really gotten. He came back last week. It was ineffective.
That's right. I mean, he hurt it against Mississippi State. And, you know, when a guy gets hurt, especially a skill position guy, and it's a knee, it takes a while for them, whether it's physically, mentally, emotionally, to feel like they're okay. And even if the doctors say, hey, Chiron, you're okay, he has to feel that he's okay. And he didn't feel that last week. But Nick Saban said he is a special player, and we'd love to have him available today.
3rd down and 7. Clayton is wide right. Travis Johnson lays off him. Mark is looking left side, goes down the middle, and he's got a receiver open inside the 40-yard line. It's Devery Henderson, number 9. And a gain of 18, another 3rd down conversion.
And this is really good work by Matt Mock in the pocket, because this was not the intended receiver. Watch Matt Mock as he goes back. He's going to look this way first. He's looking to his left. That's where his read is taking him initially. It's not there, and he comes back to a secondary receiver, Henderson, coming into the middle. Good protection and good patience by Matt Mock in the pocket.
Evenly divided rush and pass thus far. Henderson now with his 44th catch on the season is wide to the right. Clayton, bottom of the screen. Here's Mark. Slips. Pulled up. Knocked down.
Jesse Mitchell. Jesse Mitchell with his 2nd time in the backfield. And, you know, this guy, we talked to him yesterday. He's a guy. Here he is right here. Watch how quick he is off the football. going to get by Steven Peterman, the best offensive lineman that LSU has, and is into the backfield. And when we were standing by him, I mean, you know, I could have eaten a bowl of soup off the top of his head. I mean, he's not very tall, but he's very powerful and very quick.
And he goes against a good friend, Steven Peterman. They went fishing together this summer in Waver, Mississippi. Here's the pass behind Clayton for third down. Mitchell is one of the emotional leaders of this Ole Miss defense. One of the seniors, Eli Manning, saying that he came back because of his relationship with the seniors, 13 in all, 11 fifth-year seniors, two normal seniors, and Jesse Mitchell, the leader on the defense.
And he came back from a knee injury, and he came back very quickly. He had surgery in the middle of the season and came right back and bounced back very strongly. Played very well against Auburn 2 weeks ago.
Ole Miss will have three down. See if they drop eight on third down and 17.
Well, it sure looks like it.
Yes, they do. Yes. Here's Mack intercepted. Wow. Picked off, and a flag is dropped that negates the play.
Yeah, everybody stopped. Except for Matt Mock and the guy who intercepted it.
Travis Blanchard thought he had six.
Prior to the snap, false start.
And how many
Moving
is that now?
Offensive line,
four.
5 yard penalty, remains third down.
And what that suggests is that they are not concentrating as well as they need to be concentrating in a game of this magnitude. I mean, so far, Ole Miss seems to be, you know, into the game from the mental standpoint and the concentration standpoint a little bit better than LSU.
Third and 22, four wides for LSU. And a screen pass to Clayton, who is nailed by the middle linebacker. And then the ball, the tackle is made.
He's down.
Down by contact at the 46. It will be fourth down.
But good defense nonetheless. They get the mistake from their special teams. Their defense has to come right back on the field, and they respond by not letting LSU get in scoring position. Excellent defense by the Ole Miss Rebel. Chuck Drisback has to be thrilled with the way his unit is playing so far in this ballgame. An explosive LSU offense came in here on a roll, and Ole Miss has taken the game right to him.
Now Donnie Jones, and this time the return is on all the way for Ole Miss. SB will let it go, and it takes a bounce toward the end zone, limps in. Touchback, it'll come out to the 20.
You know, that punt was high enough and bounced soft enough for LSU to down it, but all the coverage guys went to the left, and the punt went to the right.
A little miscommunication.
Yeah.
CBS Sports coverage of the Home Depot SEC on CBS will continue after this word from your local station. Well, 61,000 inside bought Hemingway Stadium. We are told another 20,000 gathered about two blocks away in the Grove. And they are watching Eli Manning and the Ole Miss Rebels go on offense again. First and 10 from 20.
Only 33 yards of total offense for the Rebels so far in the ballgame.
Play fake for Manning. Comes right. Got a man open. It's Collins down the sidelines. Gets a block on Hunt. Here's Collins and a stiff arm at the 5. Down at the 3.
Well, it was single coverage.
And they're rolling down back at the 49-yard line.
Well, good news for LSU, because it was single coverage, Chris Collins against Travis Daniels, and Daniels slipped and fell. Play action so they get good protection on first down, and watch Travis Daniels, 29, slip and fall. He went for the interception and slipped. And when you have single coverage and you miss, it's a big play. Jack Hunt got blocked by Bashawn Pearson downfield.
Boy, that was a tap dance on the sideline. That was close. Yeah. Motion call. And instead of a 76-yard gain, it's a 31-yard gain, ruled out of bounds at the 49.
Boy, what a break for the LSU defense.
Oof.
You know, when you play man-to-man and when you blitz.
Dead ball. False start. Moving to the offensive line. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
It's the old saying, you live by the sword, you die by the sword. Well, it's man-to-man, and the man fell down. Now watch Collins. Right there, his right foot. I think it did go out of bounds. And it was a good call. The official was right there on the sideline. And a big break for LSU.
And now first and 15 after the false start penalty. Hand off. Oh, what a pop at the line of scrimmage. That's Bashawn Pearson, number 24.
See, this is what LSU did to Ole Miss last year when they won 14-13 down in Baton Rouge. They totally stuffed the running game. They held Ole Miss to 61 yards rushing last year, and then eventually they were able to get after Eli Manning. Will Muschamp knows that, you know, even though it's Eli Manning and he can throw, we've got to stop their run. We've got to make the game one-dimensional, and then we can go after this talented quarterback.
Second down and 60. Here's the snap back. Blitz again. Manning gets rid of it out of the backfield, coming to the right side. Brandon Jacobs, number 27. And that will give Ole Miss a third down. Well, Will Muschamp, a graduate of Georgia, the defensive coordinator. He's a man in conflict in the family today. His wife, Carol, graduated from Ole Miss. Said she went back home to Georgia, got a bunch of relatives, brought him to the game today.
Yeah.
Yeah, he said she's going to cheer for the right team.
Yeah, Colonel Reb's not signing the paycheck. I can guarantee you that.
Their son is named Jackson, as in the capital of the state. Third down and 7. Manning wants to take off, dumps it incomplete. Had him wide open.
What recognition, though. I mean, Eli was going to run, and at the last minute, saw Jacobs wide open in the middle. Watch him. He doesn't see what he likes downfield, so he says, I'm going to try to run. Whoops. Wait a minute. Little pop pass, and Jacobs not able to snag it with the right hand. But that would have certainly been another first down for Ole Miss.
Well, a 76-yard gain on the pass play to Collins. Wiped out because he stepped out of bounds after 31 yards. And all that leads to a fourth down. Here's the punt from Ridgeway, and a fair catch called at the 10-yard line by Skyler Green. Excellent punt from Ridgeway. 7-3. 8:26 to go, first half.
Through the years in this rivalry, it was 1968. Sophomore Archie Manning accounted for 3 touchdowns versus the Tigers, and a legend was born. In 69, Manning again topped 3 touchdowns, and the Rebs won again. In 1970, LSU returned 3 punts for touchdowns, an NCAA record, and rolled 61-17. The battle of the clock, LSU's Burt Jones directed 4 plays in the final 10 seconds. LSU won 17-16.
Now that one is still discussed.
Mm-hmm.
4 plays in 10 seconds.
That's good clock management.
Yes, it is. First and 10, Matt Mauk. Hand off to Vincent. Gets into the secondary and scoots out to the 19-yard line. Well, we got to see him back on August 31st. They were impressive then, and they haven't done much to disappoint. They have the one loss to Cal. And here's second down. Looks like it should be enough to get close to the first down. That's the same thing with LSU, though. That one loss to Florida. Otherwise, totally unblemished season.
And dominating, you know, other than that one game. They haven't had a lot of close games. They had a close win over Georgia. And we were at that game in Baton Rouge. But most of their games have been very one-sided. And that first running play in this series, by far their best run of the day. Before that, 13 LSU rushes for only 5 yards and 2 sacks by the Ole Miss defense. So they found a seam on that first down play with Justin Vincent.
Here's a quick flip out of the backfield, left side to Skyler Green, and it's incomplete. Gives us a chance to go down and check in with Jill Arrington.
Well, Vern, you talked about it. The Ole Miss is attributing this year's success to those fifth-year seniors from Coach Clark. Recruiting class in 99, and Jesse Mitchell told me that they just feel obligated to really give Cutcliffe a great legacy. He said these 11 seniors have such a special bond that they focus on giving Coach whatever he wants in practice every day, and it's showing on the field. And after losing 5 games in a row last year, Jesse said we don't ever want to have that losing feeling again, and they're playing like it today.
Okay, Jill, one of the keys was that they improved throughout that 5-game losing streak last year, and here is Carey almost breaking for a big one. Justin Wade, number 51. Well, a visit to Oxford is a wonderful experience, and one of the highlights came Thursday night in the Oxford Square, 3,500. Looked like 1958 all over again.
Yeah.
And among the men who spoke, the quarterback, Eli Manning, who is living a good life. He's got an apartment right there on the square, came back in part because he wanted to have the experience of a senior year.
Yeah, and I tell you, I really envy him for that. When I look back on my career, the only regret that I have...
Oh, boy. Intercepted. Jamie Mitchell.
He already got one tip by watching the quarterback's eyes. That time, he did one better. He stopped his rush because he read the screen, and he just jumped up and caught the football. Jamie Mitchell is right here. Now, he's blocked, but he reads the screen, and he gets off his block and goes straight up in the air to make the catch. He never took his eyes off the quarterback, Matt Mauch, and made a huge play.
Second interception of Mauch today, one return for a touchdown. This one gives Ole Miss the ball at the 35. There's the audible from Eli Manning. Left side, Pearson, hit and drop, no gain. Marquise Hill, number 94.
This LSU defense, I mean, you just can't say enough about how well they've played. They've only given up, before today, 89 points in 10 ball games. I mean, that is a great number. They're number one in the conference in stopping the run. Coming into today, only 61 yards per game. And then they blitz and get after you, the best third down defense in the SEC. And they've had their back against the wall with some bad field position in this game so far today, but they've held up.
On second down, stunts by the defensive line out of the backfield. Pearson almost has his head taken off. Stays inbounds and gets inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Deshaun Pearson. Marcus Spears had the tackle, missed him. Corey Webster got there. Webster, one of the better cornerbacks in the SEC. There's Webster. Made an interception in a game we saw earlier against Georgia that was extraordinary.
It's a nice play by Pearson because if he doesn't break this tackle from Marquise Hill, it's a long down situation on third down again. But he fought for about five more yards to make it third down and four.
On third down, Manning sees the blitz, goes inside, it's incomplete. Yeah. No flag.
No flag because it was good coverage by Travis Daniels and the throw was high. Because the ball was high, that enabled Daniels to get there and make a play. See, if that ball is down in the midsection of the receiver, Daniels can't make that play. But because it was high, intended for Biddle, Daniels was able to get a hand on the football.
And that will bring on the place kicker, Jonathan Nichols. 47-yard effort. And Nichols has had a superb year. He's missed once this year in 24 previous kicks. That was a 51-yarder against Florida. He's made three of four from better than 50. This is from 47 to increase the lead. He's now missed two for the year.
What a defensive stand by LSU. They've held Ole Miss to 1-for-6 on third down. They came into a sudden change situation there after the interception by Matt Mauch, and they did not give up a first down. That is great, great defense by the Tigers.
5 minutes and 13 seconds to go before halftime. It's 7-3 still. 5:13 to go before the break. Ole Miss leading 7-3. The interception for a touchdown from Travis Johnson, countered by a 45-yard field goal from Jackson for LSU. That's the scoring so far. Here's the handoff to Vincent coming to the left, and this will be a face mask penalty.
Yeah, probably just going to be the 5-yard variety.
Eric Oliver and Kelvin Robinson were in the neighborhood and look like Robinson is going to be called for the infraction.
Now this slanting defense of Ole Miss, I mean, they can make you look bad if they guess right. But if you guess right on a running play, you can gash this kind of defense. There's the face mask by Robinson.
Well, it is time now for the
Aflac
trivia question of the week. Why were all the three games in this series played in Baton Rouge from 1936 to 1964? During all of that time, they went down to the Bayou Country. What was the reason? On first and 10, draw play. Big hole. Big run. Here goes Vincent. Out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Justin Vincent, the freshman, with a 44-yard gallop.
See, when you have a defense that likes to slant, if they slant into your run, they might make you look bad. But watch as the run gets outside. The slant's coming this way, and they catch him in it. The safety was coming on a blitz. He ran right by the run, and it was just good execution by LSU. Steven Peterman leading the play. Michael Clayton blocking downfield, and a big run for the Tigers.
Vincent gets to rest, and Chiron Carey is in the backfield. Wearing number two, he gets the handoff, starts right, comes back left, and is nailed. Double teamed by Blanchard and Anderson.
That time the backside rusher, the defensive back, or the safety Blanchard, didn't run by the run. He stayed in his area, and when Carey tried to cut it back, he was there to make the tackle.
Second down, 11. Well, for the season, inside the red zone, 61%, 27 touchdowns out of 44 possessions. Nick Saban continues to pace. Michael Clayton goes wide right. And Devery Henderson is at the bottom of the screen. Play fake, roll out, more into the corner for Clayton. Got him at the 6-yard line.
Yeah, nice throw. Good timing. Good place for the ball on the outside of a big receiver. And a nice conversion for LSU. Play action, roll the quarterback out, change where his position is, and then watch the throw right to the outside of Clayton. Excellent execution.
That's a gain of 11. Well, this four-game win streak led by Matt Mauk, and during the last four, look at this. But today, two interceptions. One return for a touchdown, the other fine defensive stand by LSU. First and goal. This is Vincent bouncing right. Nailed for a loss all the way back to the 10 as Josh Cooper, number 99, led the defensive charge.
You know, you have to be impressed with how Ole Miss has played against the run. Now, they have given up a couple on this drive, but a lot of times when you see, well, they're averaging under 100 yards allowed rushing, and then you look at their passing and you see 300 yards a game, you think, well, nobody tries to run on them. But they actually have made genuine improvement in their ability to stop the run. They play a different type of defense. They always have an extra defensive back end, four defensive linemen, two linebackers, and five defensive backs, but they have played better against the run this year.
Second down, quick flip right side. Clayton cuts inside, nice. Gets a block, has a touchdown. Rodney Reed was out there, and boy, did he clear the way.
Well, and Michael Clayton waited for him. If he wasn't patient, then he would have gotten tackled short of the end zone. But Clayton had the presence to wait and let Rodney Reed get out there in front. Watch Clayton catch this ball off the line of scrimmage and then just hesitate just enough to let his guy get there. There's the block by Reed and the explosion into the end zone.
And already in this half, Clayton with 7 receptions for 74 yards and the touchdown on that last play. Chris Jackson with the extra point. It is up and it is good. And the LSU Tigers have come to Oxford and taken the lead. 10-7 LSU. Michael Clayton got popped pretty fiercely by Justin Wade as he went into the end zone. And getting some attention on the sideline. 7 catches so far, including the touchdown. Here's Mike Espy back to return the kickoff for Jackson and the LSU Tigers. 10-7, LSU gets the lead. That was a 71-yard drive in 6 plays. Second long drive of the game by LSU. Jackson's short kick will be picked up on 2 bounces on the left side by Collins. He's out to the 22-yard line. And let's take another look at that touchdown.
And the guys I want you to watch are the two seniors. These two linemen, Steven Peterman, the guard, and Rodney Reed, the tackle. Reed making his 45th start. Peterman is 36. Reed is going to get there first, and he's going to get in the way of Travis Johnson. And Peterman with a little cut block. And Clayton didn't get to quite dance right into the end zone because he took a shot at the end.
And as a result of that, he's getting some smelling salts on the sideline. That was Justin Wade who had the contact. On first down, here's Manning, play fake. Steps up, goes deep left side. Espy is down there. The pass overthrown and incomplete.
Boy, Webster in perfect position, too. And, you know, Webster was a former wide receiver, and he looked like a wide receiver on that play because he was tracking that ball like a wide receiver does, not like a defensive back does.
Well, with that last touchdown, 24-year-old Hawk tied the single-season touchdown record, touchdown passing record for LSU, Tommy Hodson, back in 1989. Matt Mauck from Jasper, Indiana. They continue to pay attention to Michael Clayton. It's second down. Blitz threatened now by the Tigers. They are coming. Manning being chased. Gets rid of it. It's caught up at the 22-yard line. A modest gain. But Eli Manning avoided a big loss.
Yeah, they went after him. And a lot of times LSU blitzes on second down to stop the run as much as anything. Anticipating run, they like to run stunts and blitzes to really stone you on a running play.
That's Michael Clayton continuing to get medical aid on the sideline. Jill Arrington reports that the word is he's fine. Just first and 10. 25 seconds to go. Mark, right side. That's the eighth catch for Michael Clayton. Eight in the first half.
And now Matt Mauck needs to be aware to use those timeouts. I mean, when you have all three of them, I mean, the whole field is open to you. They need to use this time, and they would love nothing more than to put one more score on the board here before halftime.
Now we saw a 45-yard field goal from Chris Jackson, but field goal kicking not acknowledged is one of the strengths of this bunch. Mauck and Manning in the comparison so far. Mauck has had two picked off. Goes right, finds Clayton again.
Good defense. Good defense. That play took a long time. It took 7 seconds to gain virtually nothing.
And the ball marked down at the 47-yard line. Third and one, 13 seconds to go. He did get out of bounds.
Went with the short play to try to get the first down, but it kind of backfired because Ole Miss defended it well. Now they have to use another down just to make sure they get the first down with 13 seconds left and all three timeouts in their back pocket right now.
That's Devery Henderson going in motion to the right side. Well, they keep it on the ground. A die comes to the near side and is tackled. He gets the first down. 5 seconds to go.
See that?
Got big plans for Turkey Day?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, the whole family will get together. It's going to be nice to be home for the whole day.
Ditto.
My mom and dad's house.
We're heading to Nancy's cousin's home, so Nancy's...
Oh, free and clear.
Free of cooking duty for Thanksgiving, absolutely. First down and 10. Mauck throws it away. 1 second to go. And a flag is thrown.
Well, they're going to get him for grounding because he wasn't outside the tackle box. And Ole Miss came up with a couple good defensive plays here right at the end of the half. It looked like LSU might have a chance to score again. And LSU sent him backwards.
Intentional grounding on the offense. That penalty's declined. Halftime.
Record crowd has gathered here at Vaught Hemingway. The official listed capacity is 60,500. Today, 62,552. That breaks a record that was set in their game against Florida in 2002. They have enjoyed this one as we've reached the midway point. The LSU Tiger Band. And let's go down to Jill, who is with David Cutcliffe. Jill?
Well, Coach Cutcliffe, we're used to seeing your offense putting the points on the board, but today your defense is really playing tough, keeping you in this game. Well, what will you do to open up your offensive game plan for Eli?
Well, we haven't done anything offensive. We just got to make some plays. We got to get some receivers moving, separating from coverage, and we got to protect it. We got to handle their blitz.
All right, Coach, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Jill, thank you. LSU leads it 10-7 from Oxford, Mississippi. Matt Mauch found Michael Clayton for an 11-yard touchdown. That is the difference in the game at this point. 10-7 as we get set for the start of the third quarter. The third-ranked LSU Tigers against the 15th-ranked Rebels of Ole Miss. 10-7, Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge with Jill Arrington. Lee Rogers will kick off for Ole Miss. Corey Webster is one of the deep men. Devery Henderson as well. Third quarter underway. And this will be Henderson. He is at the 1 yard line. Does not manage to make the 20. He gets out to the 17. And a moment ago, Jill Arrington chatted with Nick Saban.
Well, Coach Saban, it's been a battle of the defenses out there. You've contained Eli well, but the turnovers and penalties are hurting you a little bit. What'd you tell the offense to eliminate those?
Well, I just think we need to have more focus and poise on execution and what we're trying to do. I think we just play with too much anxiety and all that, made too many mistakes and stopped ourselves a lot. So, I think in the second quarter we started to settle down a little bit. It's going to be a tough game for us defensively because they're a good offensive team. We're going to have to continue to play well on defense, and we need to get some turnovers.
All right, Coach, thank you.
Mauch on first down with a handoff, the cutback play. They come to the left, and this one is stopped at the 21-yard line. 10-7 the ball game, and the offense of Ole Miss pretty much held in check, Tom.
Yeah, really have. I mean, they came in averaging 460 yards a game, under 100 in that first half. And we talked about it being a classic battle of strength versus strength. Well, in that first two rounds, the winner was LSU, the LSU defense. Now Ole Miss has two more quarters to try to make some corrections and see if they can find some creases against this LSU defense. But the good news for Ole Miss, as Jill was pointing out, the Ole Miss defense has kind of held its own against LSU.
On second down, no gain on this play. The handoff to Justin Vincent and Charles Anderson with the tackle. Well, we'll break it down statistically for you. At the half, total yards, LSU overwhelming edge.
Yeah.
Third down conversions.
Well, third downs is huge because when Ole Miss beat Auburn 2 weeks ago, they were 10 of 18 on third down. 1 of 7 in that first half. And when you can't convert third downs, you can't keep moving the football, and you limit your number of opportunities to make plays. Speaking of third down, here's a big one for Matt Mauch. Third
and 7. Three men down for Ole Miss. And they're going to bring 5. Mauch goes right in and out of the hands of the intended receiver. That's Craig Davis, number 85. So an incomplete pass will lead to a punt. 3 and out for LSU to open the third.
And that was a good throw by Matt Mauch. And that's not his fault. Good protection. They picked up the blitz. And a lack of concentration by Craig Davis, the freshman.
Donnie Jones on to punt for the third time today. And Mike Espy is camped at the 40-yard line, so Ole Miss, barring something unusual, should come out of this with pretty good field position.
And they had a great advantage in field position of 15 yards through the whole first half.
There's Jones, nice and high. And Espy drifts back, grabs it.
Nice coverage. Yeah. This is one of the things where LSU is best in the conference. Their punt and kick coverage. Both categories, best in the conference. Adrian May is a backup linebacker with the play there.
Well, college football on CBS, the SEC on CBS first. On Friday, Arkansas and Baton Rouge against these LSU Tigers at 2:30 Eastern time. And then our traveling circus will move into Gainesville for Florida State at Florida next Saturday at 3:30 Eastern time. College football on CBS. First down and 10, Eli Manning. They had only 3 first downs in the first half. Here's Turner, and he doesn't get much as he tries to come wide right on first down, juggling the ball, and it was recovered by Eric Rice, the tight end. Now Eli Manning with an opportunity on a national stage to finish his home career with a big day, and not the kind of numbers I think he wanted to post. 8 of 17 for 68 yards.
But the big problem is only 11 yards rushing for Ole Miss. And you know, that's been the thing that's been better for them this year. Coming into the game, averaging 160 yards a game rushing with no running game, you're one-dimensional, and it makes it very difficult against a defense as good as LSU.
Second down and 12. Again, stunts by the defensive line. Here's Manning, puts it on a rope. And he's got a first down out to the 49-yard line. The catch made by Mike Espy. That is a pickup of 18.
Yeah.
And this shows you how strong of an arm Eli Manning has, because Jack Hunt, the free safety, was in the robber position, number 8. And he's going to flash right there, but the ball had so much zip on it that Hunt couldn't get in front of it. And Espy there for the catch.
First down and 10. That's only the fourth first down. The Rebels are at the 49-yard line. And they'll try and pound it on first down. And again, Turner with nothing there.
Marquise Hill, the first one there. See, they're getting penetration. And this is a good and a pretty physical Ole Miss offensive line, but they're not able to stop the penetration of the front four of LSU. Those two tackles inside, Lavallee and Kyle Williams, Marquise Hill and Marcus Spears, the ends, all big physical guys, and they are getting the penetration inside, and that's freeing up the backers and the safeties.
Well, you see the numbers, second, fourth, and first. First in scoring. They gave up 7 in the first half. Second and 10. Manning, play fake. Into the middle, incomplete. He tried to find Flowers at the 37. It'll be third down and 9.
See, those are the kind of plays that Eli and these receivers have to come up with. When they get maximum protection like that and he gets that kind of a pocket, then they've got to make the play. And it's Eli making a good throw, and it's also the receivers getting good separation from this press coverage and getting open.
Look at the rushing yards.
Yeah.
10. Third and 10.
See, here's press coverage all the way around. Somebody has to beat press coverage and get open.
Comes Randall Gay inside, the quick receiver out to the left side. Kerry Johnson, but he gets only 2 yards, and it will be fourth down.
And see, again, that is LSU's strategy. Third down and long, instead of playing off, let's blitz. Because if we blitz more than they can block, then they have to throw hot. And if they throw hot, then we can let them catch it and tackle them short to first down. And that's exactly what they did there.
To perfection. Fifth punt for Ridgeway. Skylar Green has been held in check at the punt return position today. And he awaits this one at the 10. Leading punt returner in the country. Ridgeway, nice and high, goes over Green's head. And do they get it? Oh, no! Oh! Collins had his toes on the line.
Yep. Oh, man. Well, actually, the ball had to cross the plane because he could have been in the end zone as long as the ball didn't cross the plane. The man can actually go in the end zone as long as the ball doesn't cross the plane, but the official is ruling that the ball had crossed the plane of the end zone, and that's why it's going out to the 20. Doesn't matter where his feet are, but where the football is. Man, that was close, though.
Oh, gosh. Nice wry smile from Chris Collins, one of the 13 seniors. And back in Oxford, Eli Manning picked off for the first time in this ballgame. He's 9-11 as a starter when he throws an interception.
And last year in Baton Rouge, he threw 2 in the fourth quarter that cost him the football game. They lost 14-13, and they were driving in LSU territory both times.
Here's Mark, nailed loss at the 15-yard line. And during the timeout, this senior-driven defense of Ole Miss came out, and they were really exhorting the crowd to get with it, get pumped up.
Yeah, I'm impressed with the way they're playing. They are really playing fast. They're getting penetration. They're beating, you know, they're just beating the blocks. I thought LSU had a couple things figured out in the second quarter running the football, because they had nearly 100 yards rushing in that second quarter, but a nice stop on first down there.
Second down, 11. Mark, quarterback draw, gets by one man, gets by another, and picks up a first down out to the 28-yard line. Tackle made by Eric Oliver, number 26.
Well, this is a big play by Matt Mock. You know he's frustrated. 3 interceptions, only 3 in the last 4 games coming in today. 3 today. And so he does something else. Hey, if I'm not making it happen and throwing the football, let me do something else to move the chains and get some life going in our offense.
15 first downs to 4 for Ole Miss. That was a 12-yard gain for Mark. Here's the handoff on first down. Cut back by Vincent again. And that has been so effective for them in the ball game. right, Tim. And, of course, LSU hoping to win here, win next week at Arkansas. They still have dreams of a national championship. Here's a dive. He comes left and is cut down at the 40-yard line. Last national title for this LSU team came in 1958. And they got some help with Michigan's victory over Ohio State in terms of BCS standings. They need a Southern Cal loss in their final game against Oregon State. And they have to win out. And that would put them against Oklahoma in the Sugar Bowl. So the dream is still alive. It's a little hazy. First and 10, LSU at the 40-yard line. Here's Mark again under pressure. Really under pressure. That's going to be a flag, sure, right away.
I mean, I don't blame Matt Mock because, you know, there was nothing that he could do. There were two guys, and he wasn't going to outrun either one of them. And they are just beating blocks. Now, Matt Mock, in order for this not to be intentional grounding, he has to get outside the tackle box and throw it across the line of scrimmage. He does neither on this one, and that's why it's a penalty. But the quick pressure from this quick defensive front of Ole Miss knocks LSU backwards again. They were trying to set up a screen and just couldn't get it done.
And it was a couple of seniors, Josh Cooper, Charlie Anderson. Matt Mock hurried 11 times, sacked twice, batted fouls down twice. And he has been intercepted three times. Second and 32.
Well, despite the problems that Eli Manning and the Ole Miss offense have had today, this Ole Miss defense has responded, and they've answered every time they've been called upon so far in the ballgame.
They give the ball to a die, and he's buried. That's Ken Borns, number 45. So third and 34.
Right now, Nick Saban's telling Jimbo Fisher, hey, look, our defense is stuffing them. I don't want to turn the ball over again right here. If we call a pass, it better be something short, quick, and fast, and safe. Because I don't want to take another chance of putting our defense on the field deep in their own territory again.
And here's Mark out of the shotgun. 7:20 to go, third quarter. Mark back, screen pass. Skylar Green nailed as he gets to the 25-yard line. It'll be fourth down. Charles Clark, number 20, with the tackle. Josh Cooper with pressure. Fourth down.
And the folks here should be standing and cheering for this Ole Miss defense because they are keeping the Rebels right in this football game and keeping it a three-point game. By far the best this defense has played all season.
Now Donnie Jones is back to punt to Espy.
Nice kick.
Espy backpedals all the way to the 17-yard line. That's right. Boy, he got a terrific block. And is out to the 32-yard line.
That was Tremaine McBride, number 3, a true freshman, with an enormous block on Adrian Mapes.
58-yard punt, 15 on the return. McBride congratulated by his colleagues.
It's been a renewed intensity in recent years in the Ole Miss-LSU rivalry. 1998, Ole Miss wins in an overtime on Romero Miller touchdown pass. In 2001, Eli Manning leads a fourth quarter comeback with two touchdown passes and a 35-24 win. And last year, injured quarterback Marcus Randall came off the bench to lead LSU to a comeback 14-13 win.
All right, Jill, that was Michael Clayton scoring a year ago. Michael Clayton scored in this game from Matt Mock. The last time both these teams were ranked entering the game was 1970. Archie Manning played with a broken left arm in that game. The cast he wore is displayed in the trophy room here at Ole Miss. Out on the left side, that could be a lateral. It is not ruled a lateral. It is a forward pass.
Boy, this defense, I mean, you know, they are fun to watch. And, you know, I mentioned what Brody Croyle said, having played both LSU and Oklahoma. David Cutcliffe said the same thing to us in our meetings because he studied the Alabama-Oklahoma game when they were getting ready to play Alabama. And he said, I'll tell you, I mean, you may think I'm crazy, but this defense looks just as good as the Oklahoma defense did to me on film.
Well, thus far in this game, 1 yard rushing, one for Ole Miss. They came in averaging 160 per game. Here's the blitz again. Manning comes to the right side and he throws it behind Bill Flowers. Now, Eli Manning came back for his senior season for all the right reasons. A lot of speculation that he might declare for the NFL draft. He said he thought he owed it to the seniors who came in with him. He owed it to the younger receivers that he helped recruit, and he wanted to enjoy this whole experience. And yesterday when we chatted with him, he said, even if we lose this game, we've accomplished more this season than I thought we would.
And it's been a great, great season for him. And he is savoring every moment of it.
Talked to Peyton on Thursday night, their usual weekly phone call, and Peyton told him to do just that. Play clock winding down. 6:17 to go in the third. Ole Miss facing another third down. They're 1 of 8 on third down in this game.
And so far what LSU has done on third and long is blitz and force the quick throw. They're showing blitz off the corner right now. And here it comes.
And they do. Good blitz pickup. And here's Manning inside. Good coverage, however. Webster on Espy. Fourth down.
You know, the thing about this defense is when they blitz, okay, and then the safety comes over to cover, it's still single out here, but they do a great job of staying with their men. Corey Webster, the best cover corner on this team, that's who they go after, and he's right in position to make the play. 11 blitzes, 5 of them here in the second half now against Eli Manning.
And another punt forthcoming from Ridgeway, and this time LSU puts two men back, Skylar Green and Sharon Carey. And this will be Skylar Green at the 18-yard line. Breaks one tackle, bounces to the left, and comes down the sideline, knocked out of bounds at the 34-yard line. That's a 13-yard return for Skylar Green on CBS. Yeah. Here's Vincent on first down.
You know, you just wonder how many opportunities, how many more opportunities Ole Miss is going to get. You know, they've had 3 interceptions. They have not been able to capitalize, really. I mean, the one, obviously, they got their touchdown. They've had good field position. They've been, the game has felt like they've been in LSU's territory a lot more than LSU's been in Ole Miss's territory. And yet they're down by 3.
David Cutcliffe got his head coaching job after he served as the offensive coordinator at Tennessee, where he coached Peyton Manning. Here's Mark back.
Nice move.
Yes, it was.
What a great effort by Matt Mark. He was dead in the water again.
Mark is going to be just short of the first down on third down.
You know, one of the things that might be happening now is this Ole Miss defense that has played so well, maybe getting a little tired. That's the 7th missed tackle in the ball game, and that's what happens. Your legs go first. When you start to get tired and you start getting a little sloppy with your technique, you start missing tackles.
3rd and 1. That's Justin Wade. Double tight end set, backs in the eye. Handoff. That should be enough to move the chain. And this week's Home Depot coach's decision.
Well, Chuck Trisback is the defensive coordinator, and his decision is to play 4 defensive linemen, 2 linebackers, and 5 defensive backs. These are all the defensive backs, and that's the system that they play. And sometimes it's like having a nickel defense on the field all the time. It's good against passing. Sometimes you wonder, is it okay against a running game? Well, in a game like today, they've held their own pretty well against a good running football team with the 5 defensive backs on the field all the time.
Chuck Dirtz back in his second turn as the defensive coordinator here at Ole Miss. There's Sharon Carey going right. Tackled at the 48-yard line. Nah, Timmy, the depth of your research has no boundaries. 2nd down and 6. And this time, nothing doing. Well, B.J. Simmons lit up this Ole Miss defense. One of their 2 losses. They lost to Memphis. They lost a double-digit lead in that game. And then here on this field, 661 yards passing for Simmons of Texas Tech.
6 touchdowns. I asked Chuck Drisback about it. He said, now picture this, if you're a quarterback, you've got a minute and 30 seconds left, and you got to score a touchdown, and you have the ball. I said, okay, two-minute type offense. Now do that every time you have the football. That's what playing Texas Tech is like. That's the kind of offense they play, but Oklahoma handled them today.
Third and nine here for LSU. They lead by three. Blitz coming. Mark goes across the middle. Almost picked off for the fourth time.
I think he got a little bit locked in on Michael Clayton that time, too, on the crossing route, and may have missed Devery Henderson for a big play. Take a look at this again. Now, Henderson is going to go to the post, and Clayton's going to run the in route, and I think he kind of got locked in on Clayton and may have missed Devery Henderson down the middle for a big play.
And Donnie Jones is on the punt, fourth and nine. Espy steps away from it, and this is, oh my goodness.
Wow. Man, is that perfect. With this defense, put them on the field, with Ole Miss on there too, that is beautiful.
Matt Mock, 24-year-old junior, trying to decide whether he wants to come back for a final year. Here's Mock back, quarterback draw again. And effectively stopped at the 31-yard line. Now let's go back to New York for this Pontiac High Performance Update with Tim Brando.
Vern, you and Todd were talking about that LSU front four. How about that front six? And when there's a little bit of defensive help coming off the corner with a blitz, Mike Patterson picks it up, a defensive tackle, after Drew Olsen fumbled, and he rumbles into the end zone. It's 40-2 for number two, USC.
All right, how pretty is this scene in Oxford, Mississippi at Vaught Hemingway Stadium? Here's Mark. Got a man wide open. Boy, they gave Skylar Green a big, big cushion.
Yeah, too much cushion. Yep. Too much cushion. I mean, you respect their speed, but don't make it so easy. I mean, you've got a quarterback who's struggling a little bit, maybe struggling with his confidence. You know, he's holding on to the ball a little bit longer, not releasing it on time a little bit. He's thrown three interceptions, but you give him an easy one there for the conversion.
For the day, 14 of 27 for 133. Eli Manning, 11 of 25 for 95, one interception. First down and 10.
Big cushion for Clayton at the bottom.
Screen pass over Skylar Green's head, incomplete.
See, Matt Mock is, to me right now, because of the fact that he's had some problems, he's kind of guiding the ball. He's not just confidently setting up and throwing it. He's guiding it a little bit. And what happens is when you really try to be accurate and guide what in there, most of the time you don't throw it as well as if you just set up and let it fly.
Well, Matt Mock has been terrific on the road throughout the season. 73%. That's best in the country. Phillip Rivers, you saw from NC State, second. Here's Mock with a rollout. And he'll tuck it again and run it. It'll be third and seven or eight. Josh Cooper with the tackle. Well, sunset in Oxford. Beautiful scene and an intense game. Nick Saban has walked, I think, more miles than Lou Holtz usually does. That's the end of the third quarter with our score 10-7. We'll return to Vaught Hemingway Stadium right after this message and a word from your local station. Back at Ole Miss, Chucky Mullins is a player who is revered by this university. He came here as a freshman in 1989, injured, lived for 2 years with the injury before succumbing to it. Each year, one player is chosen for the Chucky Mullins Award. They wear his number. Jamil Northcutt has it. Now, here is Henderson, and he's in for the touchdown. My goodness. Matt Mock, Devery Henderson, 53 yards.
A third down and seven. Before that play, LSU 6 of 12 on third down, which is excellent. That's the biggest third down conversion of the ball game. Everybody on the Ole Miss defense thinking Michael Clayton, and Devery Henderson is the guy who makes the play. A little half roll to get Matt Mock out of the pocket, and then he finds the matchup he wants. Nobody near Devery Henderson for his 10th touchdown catch of the year.
And there is that susceptibility to the big play that bites Ole Miss badly. 53 yards. Henderson from Matt Mock. And it's a 17-7 lead for the Tigers. 53-yard toss for the touchdown, Todd, and with this defense, that might be enough.
Yeah, that was an excellent play. Now, Ole Miss is going to blitz, but they're playing zone behind it, and when Clayton runs the hook, Henderson is going to run the corner behind him, and I think this guy, the corner, is the guy that made a mistake because he gets caught up staying in on Michael Clayton instead of defending the deep third, and they ran the pattern right behind him for the big play and the touchdown.
Devery Henderson getting congratulations from Michael Clayton. LSU plus 40-yard pass plays, 10 now for the year. And here is the kick from Jackson. Scoots along the ground, taken near the 13-yard line. Chris Collins is going to be stopped as he gets out across the 25-yard line. Well, we talked at the beginning of the day about this Louisiana State defense, and my goodness, they exceeded even the expectations that we had.
Yeah, I thought Ole Miss would have a little more success, you know, making some plays against them, but they have not been able to block their blitz, they haven't been able to separate from the press coverage, and they haven't run the ball worth a lick. And so when you can't run at all, it puts it all on the quarterback, Eli Manning, and this LSU defense definitely as good as advertised.
And on first down, Manning is back out. 98 yards total offense through three quarters for the Rebels of Ole Miss. Here's Manning. Here comes the blitz. And Eli Manning is downed.
Marquise Hill. And that's not even a blitz. I mean, that's a four-man rush. And it's just those four beating the five up front. And here's Marquise Hill, number 94. He's just going to go right through his man to the quarterback. There's enough blockers in there to block the guys with white shirts on, but they just didn't do their job. Marquise Hill with his second sack of Eli Manning today.
At a second down and 15 after the loss of five, Manning sacked twice, intercepted once. High formation. Manning back into heavy traffic. Tay Biddle makes the grab, and that will leave a third down and about six. And we go back to New York for this Pontiac High Performance Update with Tim Brando. Timmy?
Vernon, Todd, you know it's Rivalry Saturday. Well, you got to update the Civil War. Here's Kellen Clemens, 15 yards to Dante Rosario. They lead Oregon State 28-13. Now, remember, Oregon State is next up on USC's schedule on December the 6th. A loss by them could hurt them in the computer poll.
All right, thank you, Tim. You know, it's still unanimous in this booth that those uniforms are as ugly as it gets. Third down. And Eli Manning throws this one out. A flag is thrown. We could have defensive holding here. Or shoving off. What do we got? There's Marcus Spears. Holding defense. Now let's check out the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Rushing yards, 129 for LSU, 44 of those set up the first touchdown. And Ole Miss, minus two. Get all your complete college football stats at CBSSportsline.com.
Well, they caught a break there because they were 1-for-10 on third down, and they weren't going to convert that one if they made the catch. But the penalty got them the first down.
First down and 10, backs in the eye. Play action, Manning, again, nobody there, pocket collapses.
See, there's no threat of the run. They have no fear of the running game, and so they can play pass every play. These front four guys, you know, when you don't have to play the run or respect the run, even with a play action fake, you can kind of pin your ears back and beat pass blockers, and that's what they're doing right now. Again, press coverage outside, so they force every throw to be a pressure throw. This LSU defense, 33 sacks, and they've had six different guys that have had at least three sacks this season, so it's not all the same guys.
Got a good view of Will Muschamp, the defensive coordinator. Second down and 14. Stunts again defensively. Manning drills it. Espy dives after the initial contact. It's incomplete. Travis Daniels was defending that one.
See, I really think that one of the things that happened to this LSU defense from when we saw them earlier, first of all, Jack Hunt was hurt one game, and he's a key guy because he's the quarterback of this defense. He makes all the calls in the back end. He makes sure everybody is straight and in the right spot. And he wasn't playing. And the other thing is Travis Daniels was a safety and not a full-time corner. Now that they have Daniels and Webster as the two corners, they have tremendous confidence in both of those guys so they can do a lot of other things inside with everybody else.
Third and 14, that has become a familiar refrain ringing in the ears of Eli Manning. He goes deep for Flowers. Over the shoulder catch is made!
Great read by Eli Manning. And they knew exactly what they got. The hardest blitz to pick up is the corner blitz. But he saw Webster coming. So he has the protection. That means a safety's got to come over and cover the wideout. That's a mismatch. You'd rather have a corner. They picked up the blitz. They had one-on-one with the safety, Leron Landry. And it's a perfect throw by Eli Manning. He was ready for the corner blitz. He set the protection to pick it up and then made the throw.
That's the first catch for Bill Flowers, a 43-yard gain and a first down at the 20. High formation, a 10-point ball game. And here's Deshaun Pearson. Breaks into the secondary and rips it across the 10 for a 12-yard pickup.
And that's 14 more yards rushing than they had before that play. They had minus two before that play. A nice, hard north and south run by Bashawn Pearson. And a little bounce in the step of the Ole Miss offense after two good plays.
First and goal. Collins comes near side.
LSU has been outstanding in the red zone this year. Opponents only 19 opportunities, only 9 scores.
Rosano leads the way as Pearson tries to go over right guard, but he's stuck for a loss back to the 10. Nick Saban continues to pace. Pearson, no gain, lost a couple.
9 scores against this LSU defense in the red zone. 5 touchdowns, 4 field goals. That's a 47% they've allowed points to be scored when teams have been in their red zone.
Archie Manning looks on. The nails have disappeared. Second down and goal. Pearson out of the backfield. Here's a quick setup for Manning. Nobody open, now fires it. It's incomplete at the 5-yard line. Travis Daniels defending. Third and goal.
Good coverage by LSU on the intended receivers, the two wideouts, Espy and Collins, and he tried to come back to his running back as a secondary receiver.
Third and goal. 10 touchdowns this season, fewest in the nation.
And when they get you third down in the red zone, they are they're extra tough.
And they threaten the blitz again. They are coming again. Eli Manning, Pearson, touchdown, Ole Miss.
That is how Florida scored against this LSU defense. A free release of the running back right through the middle of the defense, and nobody picked him up. When the Florida Gators upset LSU, this is how they did it.
Brandon Jacobs slipped out of the backfield and caught the touchdown.
Normally you keep the back in to block against the blitz. They free released him and nobody picked him up.
Extra point is up and good. They got a big break on a defensive holding call on third down. Eli Manning hit Bill Flowers over the shoulder for 43 yards. And now Archie Manning applauds as his youngest son hits Brandon Jacobs for the touchdown. Record crowd of 62,000 plus had been quieted for much of the second half until Brandon Jacobs went into the end zone and cut the lead to 3, 17-14. And a third down conversion, only the second of the game.
Is this any good or what? Man, oh man.
Well, this is my first trip ever. I've been doing this for a few years. I've never been to Oxford, Mississippi. I would recommend this experience in its totality to anyone who loves sports, and particularly college football. Here's the kick from Rogers. Skyler Green at the goal line will come back. Near side, watch out. Watch out again. Watch out for a third time and a fourth. And let's revisit the touchdown.
Well, LSU's a blitzing team, so when they blitz, these guys are going here with the coverage. But nobody is going to pick up Brandon Jacobs when he comes out. Even if you're blitzing linebackers, somebody has to peel off and be responsible for that guy. They called it perfectly, the exact same thing that Chris Leak hit him with when Florida upset LSU in Baton Rouge. Free release the back against the blitz and get him the ball for the touchdown.
First and 10, LSU, Matt Mauk. In at quarterback, threw 53 yards to Devery Henderson a moment ago, last possession. And this running play is dropped. Justin Wade and LP Spence collaborate for the tackle. First time these two teams have both been ranked since 1970, when Archie Manning was the quarterback. They play before a record crowd of 62,500. They came into the game with Ole Miss having won six in a row in the SEC West. LSU had dropped one game in the SEC, that to Florida. If Ole Miss wins this, they earn a trip to Atlanta. If LSU wins, they can get to Atlanta by defeating Arkansas next Friday or having Ole Miss lose to Mississippi State. And it has been as advertised.
And here's the interesting thing now for Nick Saban. When he had a 10-point lead, I think he was willing to be pretty conservative on offense. His quarterback had thrown three interceptions, and he thought, my defense is going to win this thing for me. 10-point lead is going to be pretty good. Well, now it's a 3-point lead. And now with Eli Manning on the other side with 10 minutes left in the game, he can't be conservative.
Third and 8. Blitz coming. Spence, the middle linebacker. Mauk avoids him and is caught short of the first down. LSU will have to punt.
Yeah, I just feel like what they're telling Matt Mauk right now is, when we call a pass, you take a look, and if it's there, throw it, and if it's not, you run. Don't hang on to it. Don't force it. Run, and if we have to punt and play defense, we'll punt and play defense.
Under 9 to go, a 3-point game. Donnie Jones punting for the sixth time. He's had a superb evening. Mike Espy at the 25-yard line. Good one.
Another beauty.
Yes, it is. Espy with a fair catch at the 14. 49 yards, nothing on the return. That's right, Tim. LaBelle Edwards was the head coach at BYU when they were last shut out. And that is the longest scoring streak in the country that comes to an end. First down and 10 here. Eli Manning, three fourth-quarter comebacks. Vandy, Florida, and 2 weeks ago at Auburn, he took them 80 yards. This time, they need 86 for the go-ahead touchdown. Pearson, pressure. Gets out of the backfield and scoots out near the 19-yard line. Well, doubleheader action tomorrow. Dick Enberg, Dan Dierdorf will be in Buffalo, where Peyton Manning is anxiously watching this game. That's one of the games early. Oakland at Kansas City in the second game of the doubleheader. And it begins with the NFL today at 12 noon Eastern time on CBS. Second down and 5. Backs in the eye. Corner blitz coming. They come the opposite way. There's the attempted stiff arm, but a nice tackle. Play. Wow.
Eric Alexander, the senior. Great story. I mean, this is a guy who was a backup defensive back for his first 3 years. Played on special teams. Nick Saban went to him and wanted to move him to linebacker this year. And he was a little hesitant at first. Had a great offseason. Worked harder than he'd ever worked. And he's enjoying a fine senior season as an outside linebacker.
Third and 3. Rushing yards, 134 to 11.
This is a run formation for Ole Miss, but it might be play action with maximum protection and a one-man route.
Tight end starts in motion to the right side. Play fake. Manning rolling out. Finds his receiver. That is a first down at the 30-yard line as Rick Rizzano makes his ninth catch of the season. It's good for 9 yards. Move the chain.
Yeah, they fooled him. Now, they went play action, and instead of keeping those backs in to block, they released the fullback out. Bootleg to get him out of the pocket. A quick flip to the fullback, and a nice conversion on third down. And struggles on third down throughout the whole game until the last two possessions.
Here's Rizzano, injured much of the year. Came back a couple of games ago. First down and 10. High formation on first down. Manning back under heavy pressure. Throws it deep right side. Adjustment. Throws at the 40.
How in the world did he make that throw? He's backing up. He's off balance. And he just flings it as hard as he can to the right sideline. LSU there with the pressure. Lavalet bearing down. He throws it as hard as he can with no momentum. And Flowers adjusts the ball as Travis Daniels falls down and makes the play. Remember, against Auburn 2 weeks ago, Bill Flowers was the guy who made the big catch on 3rd and 11. That one just as big.
That was a 31-yard gain, a first down just inside the 40. Draw play, left side, stiff arm, break a tackle. Tremaine Turner to the 34-yard line, a gain of 15. They were down. Eli Manning put this team on his shoulders and they went 80 yards. Got the go-ahead. They had a scare at the end but survived it 24-20. Now they're trying to come from behind. Ole Miss trails LSU by 3. First down. Backs in the eye again. Draw play. Manning, Turner, right side. Dropped. Well, that 2 weeks ago in hostile territory in Auburn with 7:20 to go in the game and Ole Miss down by 3. They completed 2 key third downs. That was Flowers. And then Lorenzo Townsend on 3rd and 5. Brandon Jacobs scored the go-ahead as Ole Miss won it 24-20.
Now, the other thing to keep in mind here for Ole Miss is they've got the best field goal kicker in the SEC. So they don't necessarily have to score a touchdown here. A field goal, possible overtime. When you're playing at home, you love your chances to win a game in overtime like that.
Well, keep it on the ground. This is Pearson. Struggles and gets inside the 20 to the 18, and it brings up another third down.
But just like 2 weeks ago, I mean, if you're David Cutcliffe, and if you're an Ole Miss fan, this is exactly what you want. The game on the line in the fourth quarter, and Eli Manning, your quarterback, with a chance to win the football game. We talked about strength versus strength. The Ole Miss offense, the LSU defense. That's what it is right now. 3rd and 4 for Eli Manning.
That's Jonathan Nichols coming into the game, the most accurate field goal kicker in the country. He has missed one today. That was from 47 yards at the other end of the field. Here's Manning rolling to his left, pulling up, lobs it deep in the end zone, incomplete.
Ole Miss lucky they didn't get a holding penalty on Marcus Spears that time, who was chasing Eli Manning. That would have made this field goal attempt a little bit tougher.
Now, Jonathan Nichols, a 6-foot junior from Greenwood, Mississippi, 23 of 25. He missed one against Florida in the win at Florida. He had 2 from 50 yards plus to win at Vanderbilt. And this will be from 36 for the tie. Cody Ridgeway is the holder, and here's Nichols' kick on the way, and he left it out to the right. That's 2.
2 misses today for the guy who was the most accurate field goal kicker in the SEC before the day started.
Snap good, hold good, kick bad. And Nichols' new team. And LSU, after the missed field goal, has the ball and a 3-point lead. Coming up next, time permitting, the Olympus College Football Today Show back in New York. Spencer and Tim on first down, on the ground. Here's Vincent for 4 yards. Well, you might have noticed the LSU players are wearing a second and six.
Timeout by Matt Mock. Didn't like what he saw. Probably a good decision.
Delay of game was called before the timeout was used. So LSU penalized five. They still do have all three timeouts. And here's Vincent charging out to the 25-yard line. It will be third down. And let's take a look at the Fidelity Investment scoring recap. First touchdown of the game on the first LSU pass of the game. Mock rolled out, was intercepted by Travis Johnson, who strolled in. That made it 7-0. And then Jackson from 45 yards out made it 7-3. Michael Clayton got this little quick screen on the right side, a couple of clearing blocks. That made it 10-7 at the half. 53-yard pass to Devery Henderson. And then the touchdown pass to Brandon Jacobs and a missed field goal kept the score at 17-14 just a moment ago as Nichols missed from 36. Third and five, Mark across the middle. LSU will be forced to punt after the incomplete pass with 2:28 to go.
And what a costly penalty the delay of game was, because instead of being second down and six, it was second and 11. And then they had the third down play. And now they've got to give the football back to Eli Manning. A lot of costly little mental mistakes by the LSU Tigers today in the ballgame.
Donnie Jones on the punt. Mike Espy, this time at the 35-yard line.
Wow, another bomb.
Boy, he really boomed it all the way back to the 16. Espy to the 31-yard line. And as Ole Miss comes back on the field for perhaps the final time, let's go down to Jill.
Well, Vern, you were talking about Jeff Boss and how much he means to LSU. Well, Coach Saban said Jeff was as close to and respected by the players than anyone else that the team's been around. Everyone told us how selfless and giving he was with his unmistakable high energy all the time. And Chad LaVallee told me that they were so sad to see him go that he won't have to suffer anymore. He's always lifted everyone else's spirit, and now they're glad to see his spirit lifted too.
All right, Jill. Eli Manning, Ole Miss, 17-14, ball on the 32.
2 minutes and 16 seconds left. Ole Miss with two timeouts left in the ballgame.
Manning fakes the draw, avoids the tackle, fires it out, incomplete.
Nice coverage. Randall Gay on coverage. Marquise Hill, who's had a monster game for LSU, applying the pressure to Eli Manning. Eli Manning had to run, and when he had to move, the ball was a little high. And Randall Gay able to strip it out before the catch was made. But Marquise Hill has just played outstanding today for Nick Saban's defense.
Total defense so far in this game, Ole Miss with 232 yards, second and 10. Play fake again. Manning off the back. And there's Espy open. Can't hang on. He was bumped by Jack Hunt.
Well, Corey Webster was totally lost. Number 13, who was in coverage. But he got help from his safety. But the first help came from Marquise Hill, who's going to be right into the lap of Eli Manning. Hit the arm as he's throwing Marcus Spears, rather. Got 84 and 94 mixed up. But Jack Hunt at the end of the play bailed out his partner out there, Corey Webster, because Webster was turned completely around and Hunt able to be there to knock the ball out.
Third and 10. 2:01 to go. LSU leads by three. Four-man rush this time. Manning inside. Oh, almost picked off. Corey Webster.
Boy, he had a beat on it, didn't he? Four interceptions on the season. Has great instincts and a great knack for the football. And he just slipped right underneath Biddle and almost made a huge play.
Fourth and 10, 1:55 remaining. And Ole Miss will use a timeout to chat about this. 17-14 LSU. Just a moment ago, while we were away, both squads, the respective squads in their entirety, gathered around the head coaches. urging them on. And now, 4th and 10, David Cutcliffe has given the play to Eli Manning. Nick Saban's defense has been called, and we're about set.
One thing LSU needs to be alert for, if they're going to pressure Eli Manning, make sure that no running back slips out unaccounted for. They got him for the touchdown by doing that earlier. Two backs in the ballgame right now, Brandon Jacobs and Rick Rosano, both behind Eli Manning.
4th and 10. And the pressure is coming. Manning trips.
He got stepped on by his own guy.
It's all over. And Spears was in the middle of it.
And LSU is bringing pressure, and they've been pushing and pushing and pushing the whole game. And just, again, the inside push, right where the two centers and the guard, it was Buckles, the left guard, who stepped on the foot of Eli Manning, but he got driven back. Chad Lavallee drove him right back into the quarterback, Eli Manning. That inside pressure by this LSU defense, devastating.
1:50 to go, the ball exchanged, and LSU will keep it on the ground as Vincent dances through and gets to the 22-yard line. Ole Miss can stop it just one more time.
There's Chad Lavallee. We talked about him being the anchor of this defense. He just drives guys back, and the foot of Buckle stepped on Eli Manning. And the hope for a fantastic finish dashed in one moment.
Meanwhile, the emotional response of Marcus Spears as the dream remains attainable for LSU. And Archie Manning and his wife Olivia, their oldest son Cooper, his wife Ellen, an anticlimactic end to a saga that might have been written by William Faulkner here at Ole Miss. As Archie played here, Peyton went to Tennessee, Eli came back for the best of reasons, and it all comes to naught with 1:37 to go. Now, Ole Miss, if this stands as a 17-14 defeat for Ole Miss, LSU still has a game to play against Arkansas, and they must defeat Arkansas to get into the SEC championship game.
LSU will play Arkansas in Baton Rouge in 6 days. Ole Miss will play Mississippi State in the Egg Bowl in Starkville in 5 days. So both teams with a short week and an important game to finish their season.
On second down, Vincent, the freshman.
The only thing right now that can hurt LSU, and remember, you've got freshman running backs in there, is if they get a little bit loose carrying the football. Because right now, with no timeouts, Ole Miss, all they can hope to do is to strip the football out. So Matt Mock needs to tell these guys, Justin Vincent, the redshirt freshman, hey, keep both arms on the football, because the first guy is going to try to stand you up so another guy can come and strip the football out. If you feel them stuck to tug at the ball, get down on the ground.
3rd and 3. They hand it off to Vincent over the top. It'll be 4th down with 52 seconds to go.
I think LSU will just, I mean, they'll go for this. I mean, there's no point in kicking a field goal because, again, then you get in a situation they could possibly block the field goal. And they let this clock go down as far as they can.
Now the Tigers come into Oxford for only the 11th time since this series began in 1894. And for Eli Manning, hopes of a trip to the SEC title game have perhaps evaporated. 4th and 1. Timeout. LSU. Now let's take a look at the play of the game presented by Wrangler 5-star Premium Denim. It's called by Jim Hawthorne of LSU to Debrie Henderson.
And he will roll to the far side. Looks, Cox, and fires those deep. He's got Debrie Henderson. He's got it at the 15, 10, 5. He scores! Touchdown, Tigers!
In Indeed he did, and that is the margin of difference in this game. Jonathan Nichols with a missed field goal from 36 yards out that could have tied it. Well, we've taken the vote in spite of Batman's presence. And we have declared all 11 or 16 or 25, how many ever played, for the LSU defense as the collective player of the game. 27 yards rushing, 227 yards total. They sacked Eli Manning four times and picked him off once.
And it was strength on strength. The best offense in the conference against one of the two best defenses, Georgia and LSU. They kind of split one and two on all the major categories. But definitely the best scoring defense, not only in the SEC, but in the country coming into today.
High formation. They'll toss it to Vincent. He goes left. And they'll stop the clock now with 9 seconds to go to see if indeed he picked up the first down. And if not, it would be one more play for Eli Manning and the Ole Miss Rebels.
Well, possibly,
looks like they'll have it.
Yeah, possibly two plays with 9 seconds.
Right.
If they just throw a deep out route to try to get the ball out to around the 40 and then take one shot at the end zone.
Manning and his teammates on the field trailing by three.
You know, they technically only need a field goal to try to force overtime, but the ability to get into field goal range with 9 seconds with the ball on the 18, very, very difficult. So they'll try to get to about the 40 and then take one shot at the end zone.
Motion left tackle, 5-yard penalty, Ole Miss.
I've been very impressed with the front four of LSU. The front guys up there, we talked about the whole defense being the player of the game. Marquise Hill with two sacks today.
Ball start. Movement in the offensive line. 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Chad Lavallee, the anchor, the spiritual leader of this defense. Kyle Williams, the other inside guy. Marcus Spears, the defensive end.
First and 15 with 9 seconds remaining. Manning rolling out, being chased, and puts it up for grabs. There's Collins down there, and looks like an alley-oop in the end zone, but it's at the 45, and this one is in the bank.